Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's have a quick look at the new App Store Connect. Okay, so it is the weekend and I'm in the office. The weather outside is sunny and beautiful and hot, just the way that I like it, but I have to catch up on a bit of work because I had so many meetings during the week and we're short-staffed and everything like that, so I needed to get a few things done before Monday. So, I had this task where I had the developers had finished working on this iPhone project, and all I had to do was just come in, test it out, compile it, and put it up onto the onto iTunesConnect so we could put it onto test flight. However, I haven't been on iTunesConnect for like the last several weeks, and they did a big rebrand at the beginning of June. There was announced at the WWDC that iTunesConnect is now called App Store Connect, and when I first saw it, I panicked because I thought this is going to take longer than I thought. So have a look at my screen here. Right, this is the new App Store Connect, so it's a new rebrand, but luckily, they haven't made a lot of changes yet, aside from the look and feel. At least nothing that I could see. The biggest changes I see have been in sales and trends. So here you can see up in the corner is now called App Store Connect, which makes total sense, right? And we've got the same things. We've got My Apps, App Analytics, Sales and Trends, everything like that, the payments. And then also this notice up here at the top saying that later in the summer, they're going to be, what I believe this means is that they're going to be consolidating the Apple developer website and App Store Connect, which makes total sense. It never made sense to me that I have to get my certificates on one website and do all the App Store stuff on another website, right? And it was always, every time I have a client, I have to request access to both of them. And then, of course, here you see I have to approve a new terms and conditions change, a new contract, which is what stopped me in my tracks today, too. So, like I said, putting everything off the last minute, I thought I'll get them this test flight build for Monday, right? But I can't because I need the client to approve the terms and conditions on their App Store account. So that's one of the things that happens all the time. If you work with clients, you always have that. There's certain things you have trouble with the App Store. It's like if you're trying to do something to a tight deadline, there's going to be a terms and conditions change right before that, and the client has to go find the person who's the signatory to make those approve those changes. And the second thing is that your clients once a year will contact you and say that all the apps have gone missing, and then you just politely tell them that their developer account expired and they just need to renew it. I mean, that's happened like half a dozen times to me. So anyway, so this new interface here, I think it's kind of nice. I don't like change, but I mean, so we got the My Apps, App Analytics, everything kind of fits in the same way, everything looks the same way. If I go into Sales and Trends, I'm hesitant to show you Sales and Trends because at the end of May, with the GDPR and everything, we removed most of our apps. So the revenue is low, the downloads are low, and this thing's a bit slow. But I do like the way this looks as opposed to the way it looked before. We have a lot more information here, although it's just taking the same stuff and putting it into, you know, quick dashboard type thing so you can see it really quickly. For me, I always just go to proceeds. I know they talk about the units. The downloads is something that I used to look at all the time. The downloads was what I was most concerned with. But with the App Store, as opposed to Google Play, I'm more concerned with purchases or in-app purchases or purchases than I am with downloads. Because the downloads, I know what those are based on the impressions on AdMob when I check that every day. So I always go to proceeds. They give you sales and proceeds, which is great that they do that. But sales is the full sales, and then the proceeds is that minus the 30% cut that they take, so you can see what that is. So like if I show you my proceeds here, it's really low. It's like $8 a day or something like that. And as opposed to 3 months ago, it was like 30. So yeah, $5, $8. It's like, oh, it's depressing. But anyway, so these are the big changes here. Now, one of the things, if you're an app developer and you work for both, if you do both, you know, Apple stuff and you do Google stuff, you'll see that the developer experience is very different for both of them. Like here you can see everything is very clean. It's like the iPhone. They're thinking they don't want to overload you with too much information. App Analytics is probably the best place to go to look at the data, where you have everything that looks a bit more like Google Play. And of course it's going to take ages to load, right? But in Google Play has always been so here you can see all the statistics. If you want to drill down to see how many page views, let's go into this guy here. if you want to see how many page views you have. The same thing as the app acquisition report on Google Play. You've got all this, although you have the extra thing here where you have the impressions. So how many times is it actually showing up? So I see it shows up in search, you know, 400,000 times, and then 45,000 is actually people actually clicking in to view the page. Out of that, 15,000. So my conversion rate is, you know, but it is what it is, and then the purchases and all that kind of stuff. Now, Google Play, of course, is they overload you with data as soon as you go into it. So here's like if I go into Ear Agent, I can see the I could quickly see installs by user, and then drill down into all those bits of information. And as soon as I go into the developer console, I can see everything at a glance. Some of my apps need attention. I don't know if you guys get this on Google Play, and I know I'm jumping around between Apple and Google Play here quite a lot. I've had them start picking on apps that I've unpublished ages ago. Like they're saying, oh, this one is missing content rating, or this one is missing this is missing that. And I'm like, it hasn't been live for like 2 years, but so I'm getting all these things here. So I either have to put them live and make those changes and then unpublish them, or just ignore them and hope that's not going to do. So, you know, Google Play is, it just overloads you with information. I kind of like that. As a developer, I like having more information than I need because it allows you to drill down a little bit more. But anyway, it's just the two different experiences. I don't really have a lot to talk about here because today is my first experience really looking at App Store Connect, and I don't see a lot of changes yet, but I don't know. What do you guys think? For those of you guys who are Apple developers specifically, I mean, how do you find the new interface? Because right now I don't see any big differences, but apparently there's a lot of things in the pipeline coming forward. Like it's going to be easier to do test flight. And a test flight is something, if you do client work, we use test flight all the time. I mean, it's just, we could do like 10 or 20 test flight builds before we actually go live with a client application. So anyway, that's just a really quick today. I hope you guys are having a fantastic weekend, and I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.